join us on a journey and meet a lot of startup founders. And for that, subscribe to the channel. And also, if you don't want to miss anything, then click on the bell icon and never, ever, ever miss anything about High on Startup. So welcome to High on Startup, and this time we are with Mr. Omkar on Edugain. Now I want to know about, are we gaining education when you're talking about this startup? But let's get to know more about it from the founder himself. So please tell us, what is the concept and the idea behind Edugain?
Okay, so the concept is simple. It has been talked about many a times. Education, it is moving on the cloud, apart from many other things which are. So. But then the way we are trying to move education to cloud is a bit different. We kind of wish to augment learning or gaining education the way it's being done with an online learning system. So we want to provide to parents a virtual assistant which could be, you know, of help to the parent to teach his child. And similarly, a virtual assistant to a teacher to teach whole of its class.
Wow. Yeah.
So so there's a lot of technology involved in that learning system which we are building. And we're getting a good traction to start.
How did you, you're just giving a question now here. How did you get to this idea? This is interesting.
Yeah, so we basically got started when we thought that we should be making something which we would use with our own kids.
Okay.
So it was my wife and wife of my friend, basically family friends, which were on sabbatical from their IT jobs. They were at home, they were IT professionals, and they had got young kids, and then they had utilized their talent. And then they had a problem that they were limited again on time, because even if they're at home and if they're with kids, they will always be on short on time.
Yeah.
Now, and that's what so many mothers would be, so many parents would be at home. So, if so many things to take care of, and then and to make sure that their kids they are gaining education. So it is a lot of work. So what we did was they created an initial system for their own use, for our own use, and then we started thinking, oh, this is something good, and we should release it to the public. And that's what they did. They did, and it started getting traction from first month itself.
Wow. Yeah, so, when did you really start? When did you go live with it?
I think it was around 2012-2013. So it was the very first alpha beta version was. That was the time when it started gaining traction.
And you actually got on board with the entire plan on?
Yeah, that happened last year in April.
Okay.
Yeah, this when I thought probably that that initial prototype, initial idea was worth giving full-time consideration.
And how many people are working in Edugain?
Now we are a team of around 7 people.
Okay. Yeah. Evolving, yeah, really nice. Yeah. So tell me how the experience has been, and what all are the challenges you face, because it's a virtual environment that you're using, and does it kill the gap between the, you know, the generation gap that is between parents and children, because it gives them another objective to, you know, interact with one another and talk about. So how does that
happen? There's none, I think. The platform, the system, it recognizes that it has two different kinds of audiences.
Okay.
So when a child uses Edugain, what gets served to him is what would interest him, what would interest him or her. Mm. And similarly,
for the parents.
For the parent, of course.
They will simple, really nice.
Stuff they would like to learn.
And when you were planning to go on board, what were the challenges you faced, if I may ask?
So far, the challenges, I don't think there have been any challenges per se.
Wow, you did not face challenges.
Yeah, that's we did. Yeah. So the challenge is getting the kind of growth which we would like to. So the kind of growth which we have got so far is not bad, but then our appetite for growth is much larger than what we want.
And I think as long as you have a nice appetite, you'll keep on working and driving on. So that's great.
So that's the challenge.
That sounds more like a nice plan to me instead of a challenge. But what would you want to say to the viewers, to the parents, to probably the children who are college students who are watching this video right now? Like, what would you want to convey them a message about your Edugain, the startup that you have?
Okay, yeah, so for the message to the parents, my strong message is, the very first would be, you don't need to rely only on tuitions. You can be the best tutor your child can ever get if you have Edugain by your side. This is a very strong statement I do believe that I would like to make.
And what is it that you do when you need to get high on education?
It's again my startup, you know, so it never leaves my mind, so and it always keeps me on. Even if I'm sleeping, I'm not really sleeping.
Brilliant. Mr. Om is actually high on his startup because it's Edugain, it's knowledgeable, and also it is his work and ambition. And beautiful part is they don't face any challenges. Now, I'll tell you they do, but they won't tell about them because they don't see anything as a challenge. And I think that positive attitude is what is required in the startups today. And that's why I'll tell you, if you want more positive energy to be flowing through, then you need to subscribe to this channel and you need to check out Edugain right now. The link is down below. Keep subscribing to our channel.